All right. Only 20 minutes late. I'm gonna drop the music just lightly. Ignore that flashing oxygen warning. Yeah, I'm definitely not doing this. This is what I was testing with. I don't think it'll work. I mean, it might. I'm not gonna actually delete. I'm not gonna delete it. Just yet. Oh yeah, I should probably explain what I'm doing. So in case you haven't watched the most recent episode of Overengineering Survival, or you're tuning in for the first time. Oh, hey Drax, you know what? I need to bring chat into a good spot because for some reason OBS is cutting off half of it. Yeah, exactly. A streamer is never early or they late. They start exactly when they are meant to. Yep. Ooh, the wind is blowing shit around. It does exist. Yeah, that's why they appear to be very expensive. The idea behind that was this would detach and this would just fly back to base. But I don't think that's really worth it. I'm still gonna go with the large grid warhead because it is the easiest way to destroy the bases. But I think I'm gonna flip this around. So the way I had it before was I had like the antenna and remote control and whatnot in the front here so I could see what I was doing. And then in the back was the warhead. I'm gonna swap that around. Oh yeah, I also should say why there's bulletproof glass, because bulletproof glass surprisingly is very bulletproof. far more bulletproof than steel armor. So, and I can see through it. So we'll keep this shell as is. Really? Well, that went well. It's fine. I'll just rebuild it. You know what? Also, become station. Hello. Warhead. So what I think I'm gonna end up doing is I'm gonna do warhead. Which way are the wings on this? I say wings in quotation marks. They're not really wings. So actually, I don't think it would matter. Because I don't think large grid actually has lift. I think it just has drag. Which will still allow us to fly. Yeah, no, glass is definitely a lot less expensive than heavy armor. Especially because I don't actually have a source of cobalt. I have a rock, like one of the boulders that I've been mining for my cobalt. I think it's almost gone. Camera. Now I can put the glass back on the front.
Energy low.
You know, I guess I don't need these displays here either. Oh no, I still do to hold the front on. Yeah, that's the only flaw I foresee in this plan, is I would have to extend it one out further for this front panel to actually be held on with something more resilient than displays. So that could go wrong. So, it's going nighttime. The next problem I come to is for the connection. The easiest way of doing it would be to have a large rotor, which in all honesty isn't that expensive. It's made from completely out of, I can make it all from stone, so it's it just comes down to how many parts am I willing to spend to build something. And honestly, I don't really care. Because I'm hoping that taking out, actually, I don't think the base exists in this test world. No, it doesn't. The base used to be here.
Energy critical.
You can see what a large brick warhead will do. But we'll have to take out possibly two bases. I think I'm far enough away that this base up here will ignore me. And then this one just spawned in from while I was doing my testing, so it's not actually in the actual world. So I think we'll only need to take out one base total. So I only will have to hopefully build one of these. Yeah. The problem is, attaching it to the 3x3 is, there's no easy way of doing that because King doesn't have the option to make it place a 3x3. It always does a 1x1 now. Which is fine. Because I think, I honestly only need one battery. If that.
No energy.
You know what? It's daytime. I'm in spectator. I don't care that I have no energy. Yeah, I can do that, but again, it just comes down to, is it worth it? Is this the right way around? No. It's this one. No. Not this one either. Gotta be one of these. There we go. Because on the back end, I think all I really need to do is have the antenna. Remote control. Sufficient gyro. That may be too much. Maybe not enough. I don't know yet. Some tanks, which I can sneak in. Can I put auto-rotate? No, auto-rotate is not on. It's just deciding to auto-rotate. Do you mean you cannot place? There might be a proper way I have to build this. Comes time. Alright. Can I place glass back on top of that? No! And it is kind of important that this thing be surrounded by bulletproof glass, so. Or although, actually, the back end? Because this can be hydrogen powered. Because I'm fairly certain hydrogen is... has more thrust than the atmospheric. Just always. Unless I'm wrong about that, which I totally could be. Is there a way that I can fit many hydrogen tank on each side of these? I think so. Go around in a spiral. Yeah. I'm gonna be launching it from home base. At least that's the plan. Or I will be launching it from building it at home base and then launching it from like the rail line or something.
No energy.
Depending on how much fuel I have. Because I want a fairly decent range with this thing, because I want to be able to use it to take out not just the one base that's currently in my way, but like all of them. Whenever that happens. Why don't I actually put proper mirror on? Trying to think how I'd pipe this up. I guess we have the small connectors now, don't we? It's So, in fact, what I would probably just do is, actually, probably putting it on the top would be better. For right now, just while we do testing. Put it Alt Shift. Nope. Control Shift. I scrolled right past ice. Compressor? What the hell is a compressor? Fills up. There we go. And then let's. I have no energy. There's also that thought, but I would have to build a flying wing. Which, I mean, is totally doable. View camera. Arm warhead. Antenna, we'll just mix the range for right now. It's like, oh no, I agree, like, building a flying wing would be a lot easier. The thing is, though, I don't have a runway. Once I get to the ice lake and I've got a flat area where I can take off easily, I 100% agree. I'm building, like, a big old flying wing bomber for this. It just, for right now, because I, like, every single landing I've done with the fly detector, I've blown off the tail, or I've blown off one of the wings. I don't know if it was on stream or off camera, but I was doing testing with my brother for something a while back, and we were flying around with the fly detector and another plane. And taking off, I blew up like 6 times. where 14%. Okay, that's good enough probably for testing. What? Oh, right, it's fucking station. This is awkward. Let me go into the truck. And we'll see how well this thing flies. I'm just gonna drop it from really high up first. Oh yeah, you're not gonna let me pay something while on it. Test bomb control. Okay, I can probably take out some of those, Yep, I can disable some of those gyros. Oh, is it more stable going backwards? I might. I might need to look at the design, the aerodynamics on this thing a bit. It seems to be more aerodynamically stable falling backwards. Nope, I can't control it. I'm falling backwards! Okay, what actually is the aerodynamics of this thing? This is not bad. I think it's just center mass is... Drag needs to be behind mass. So I need to do something. That turned into a station. And that fell over. All right, well, station it is. You could use a vector thrust wing. I mean, I could. You're right. If I was gonna make a flyer for it. I'm not saying I won't try that this stream. I'm not saying it's not a good idea. It is a good idea. It's probably the better idea. I don't want the center. It's this one. Yeah, there's like... Because I can't place anything here. Yep, I guess I'm just gonna deal with this. Well, I guess I could do sloped ones, maybe? Start with. Make them look a little bit nicer. Interesting. Actually, that probably would work better. Oh, but I can't do it on both. The good news is I can pull. It's not possible to convert to a ship. It already was a ship. Oh yeah, I also love how stupidly strong bulletproof glass is. It's kinda dumb. Is drag behind mass now? It is. Not, I don't think it's far enough behind, but it is. That's fine. Actually, you know what I can do? I can take out these things. These things don't help at all. Because there's no flying. It can hold itself up! And then fall back into a hole. Yeah, that'll probably work.
Energy low.
Loading again. Do I have like damage off somehow? Or is it just because this is upgraded and it's indestructible? The damage is on! Alright. Let's try for another flight test. Wow.
Energy low.
Camera's been destroyed. I guess. Or not.
Energy low.
Fuck. It flies. Sort of. Okay, actually, I think it's gonna be. So this is a not for YouTube missile, which has run out of power. It's very stable falling downwards, though.
Energy critical.
What did I hit? Did it hit the ice, like, didn't it?
No energy.
There it is. Did the warhead not detonate? That doesn't feel like a warhead detonation. That feels like it was destroyed. Like, the grid got destroyed and deformed the voxels. Oh, I have no energy. Well, at least we can test to see what it looks like. Yeah, that's not a warhead detonation, I don't think. Yeah, no, definitely not, because there's no way the back end would have survived. Let's get some energy so I can control this stupid thing. Plan number two is I just do this and just drop that once that battery's charged. Because I know this'll work. This'll, if I drop it from really high, I can aim this. And that's kind of what I'm leaning towards right now. Warhead arm. Where are you? Oh, the thruster is firing still. Whee! That's a warhead detonation. So, why was it not doing that before with the... Ah, crud. Whoa. Oh, I think my mouse is dead. Okay, my mouse is dying. 1 second. There we go. We're good. I think I accidentally destroyed all of the... Yeah, I did. Whoopsies. We'll just rebuild the test bomb. It's fine. Right. Got to turn up the thruster. And this one doesn't have a camera for some reason. Wait, where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, I didn't hit the detonate on the warhead. Whoopsies. The warhead. Kaboom. The fuck? I hit kaboom on the warhead. How is this still here? I hit kaboom! What? Toggle that off. Arm warhead, copy it, and follow one of these down. What the heck is going on? Nope, that was too fast. It's not exploding! The warhead is being disintegrated! What the fuck? Hold up. Okay. Is this just bulletproof glass doing this? I have a plan. Where's the ice lake? Over here. Okay. Because it'll keep the same velocity. I'm fault. I'm falling at, right? I think I went a bit too high up.
Okay, so it's not being slowed down by drag. Because it's falling faster than 85 meters per second. And boom. Okay, so this explodes. Wait. No, it didn't explode.
Energy low.
That wasn't... That was a block being destroyed via... The, like, colliding with something. Like, not a, detonating because it detonated. What? It survived that too? Is bulletproof glass just indestructible? Is that what this is? If I... So that explodes when it hits. Okay, hold on.
Energy critical.
The fuck? Get a place, please. Alright. Hopefully I don't miss. Okay, so it will still destroy blocks. Okay, so it will still detonate blocks. This is so stupid.
Alright, now I have to know, will this actually detonate a research? Like, because it does not, when I hit the voxels, it's not doing the explosive damage of it hitting the voxels. It's just doing the impact damage of the voxels, hitting the voxels. So, will it, I want to give this enough chance to accelerate. Hopefully that'll hit. I don't think it will. No. It's gonna miss. Shit, they destroyed it. What's that idea? Well, let's give it a bit more than 800 meters to accelerate. Something tells me I'm not anywhere near on target, but... Nope, way off. You guys won't care if I, I'll just stand here for a minute. Fly straight up. That is actually quite annoying. Oh. Alright, part of me is wondering if I just, you know what, just build a tank. If I build a tank, I could probably just outrange the thing and just blow them all up. So you know what? Let's go back to base. Let's do the other half of the stream I wanted to do. Here's the crane. Where am I headed? This. I want to add another piston onto this thing. Oh, batteries are off, aren't they? folding that up, how would that... Let me up. So the ones that have to get deleted are these. Goodbye. Oh yeah, I should actually, hold on. I need to track this. Hey. Sims VR right now. Oh yeah, it feels sluggish. Don't like this, but okay. Let's put some railings on the top here. Not just railings, any of these things. I want to make sure this will actually fold. Did I just have the right catwalk? Thank you. That's gonna collide. I like having the railings up here. It makes it feel safer. I mean, if I put a full block in the middle, that would allow me to do it. But
Or do I just...
I also like having the extending ramp. Or, like, the extending guard railing as well. So, you know what? No, I'm just gonna put a block in the middle. It's fine. All for aesthetics. The most important thing when building. Who cares about function? That looks so dumb folded up. Oh god. Oh man, I can't do that. I'm gonna have to do that. And I think we're just gonna have to get rid of part of the railing. We'll figure out the railing after. Fine, in the main save, half the railings exploded anyways. Although that is an issue. The fact that my connector is gonna be bumping with gonna be bumping into the welder. Wrong way. Because I can't refill my cargo if it's like that. How would I connect? How far back do I have to go to leave that connector free? Far enough. This is an option. An option I'm not gonna enjoy doing, but it's an option nonetheless. Having the cargo there is fine, actually. I think I have to go further out still. Be one further out? Where's my connector? There it is. Alright. There we go. Because at least this way I can still connect. Not as pretty. But a lot of extra battery power on the back, and it'll mean I can reach higher heights, which is what I want for this crane. So I think I'll end up doing something like this next episode probably, and fuck it. Let's try and design a flying wing. Go back to the ice. Yeah, I'll just go back to the ice lake. Or do I try and drop this from orbit? Where's the rocket? the rocket that's probably slight. The batteries, I think, are slightly on fire, unless I was smart enough to turn them off beforehand. Yeah, no, the battery melted. Nah, that's too high. How long have we been going for? An hour 16? Alright. What's the range at which the bases will call in for help? Where's the close base? Because you know what? Sometimes the simplest solution is just a really big gun. And what's the range of the what's the cannon called? Where are my guns? Assault cannon. Yeah, this is assault cannon. Artillery. Can I build artillery cannon ammo? Does that require uranium? Auto cannon is, assault cannon is 1k, okay. Which, I mean, we're 1.5 away from this thing. Is it gonna call in for help at all? Hello? Okay, let's go to one I haven't messed with before. This thing still drives. This was my rover from season one. My back. Time can never be your trusted friend or your sworn ally. No, it's the harshest mistress of all. And life is just a chain of moments spent, a thousand hellos and goodbyes. I think I'm okay. I'm just streaming a blank screen, so love like ours can lead out its call. Thank you. Okay, I am back alive.
Both Space Engineers and OBS just died. We good? Space Engineers, you alright? I think there just might be too much shit in this world. We go. Sim speed back at 9.9. That's good. I want to go to the further away one. Okay, and this time I think we'll place in a vehicle that has less subgrids. Which isn't boding well for this world. When are you gonna spawn in drones to blow me up? Not like set to untargetable, am I? Oh, I am. Though, I've still been getting the messages that, like, hello? Base? Are you gonna call in drone support? Well, I mean, if it's not gonna call in drone support. Oh, now it calls in drone support. Ow. How did you flip over? I clearly need to do some extra testing with the bases, because I don't understand how the reinforcements work. Oh, and that was invulnerable, not untargetable anyways. I have to hop into like. Okay, it spawned in drones. And I am a kilometer away. I don't understand. Also, I think they're trying to murder my unknown signal. Alright, goodbye, mosquito. And you're just flying. Yeah, you were shot up my unknown signal and then you fell into the ground. By the way, it falling into the ground has nothing to do with any of the mods I have installed. It just fell into the ground. Because none of the mods I have that affect thrust affect NPCs. So it just fell on the ground. Okay. I don't know why I can hear. I wanted to go here. Yeah, artillery does require uranium, so we can't build artillery, so the best we can do is assault. So, artillery, and then assault. What are the ranges on these? Artillery has a range of 800 meters? Or is it just their aiming radius is 800 meters?
That feels incorrect. Google this. Okay, the assault cannon has a range of 1,400 meters. At least according to Reddit. The artillery has a range of 2,000 meters. Or, sorry, yeah, 2,000 meters. So, I think... I think I'm gonna design a vehicle that just... A small vehicle. God, this can take forever to build, though. Doesn't matter how small I make it. Right now, I'm just figuring out the size of a vehicle. It's not... Probably work on this a bit more off camera. So, honestly, I probably want maybe two artillery cannons. Or assault cannons, or whatever the hell they're called. With overlapping field of fire. So actually, I probably could bring that in a bit. Yeah. The hitbox on that? No. Oh, that's actually pretty far hitbox. Something like that, and then off the sides. I could build a vehicle about this big. I think this would be able to take out a base easily enough. I think that's doable. Not going to enjoy building it, considering I still haven't finished building any of this shit. but... Yeah. So I think that's the plan. I think next episode, I'll either start working on a large grid rover that's armed to the teeth. Problem is, I won't have any of my actual infrastructure. It'll all have to be built. Where's the rail line? That's not it. Rail line? Yeah, all of it will have to be built over here. Which means probably setting up a refinery and assembler down here, because this is iron, so I have iron. So... Either I ship it all here, or I build a refinery and assembler here. Actually, wait. I have a refinery and assembler here. How much is in here? $6,600 That's probably not enough. But it'll be a good enough start. So, yeah, okay, I think that's the plan, then. Next episode, I will upgrade the crane so I can use it to actually build more of the base around here so it can reach higher and whatnot. 'Cause I do want to finish this area up at some point. And then we'll work on a large grid rover, roughly this size. It's gonna be so many parts. To take out that base, and then we can get to the ice lake. So yeah, I'm gonna probably end it off here. Because it is getting a bit late for me. So. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Next episode will be out either... next week or the week after that. Depends. I've got some schoolwork I gotta do. So, depends how much time I have this weekend. And there might be a Dark Souls stream on Twitch tomorrow night. And also, I have started re-editing the Dark Souls streams, so those might be uploaded at some point. Again, Space Engineers will take priority over Dark Souls, so... you'll see Space Engineers before Dark Souls. But yeah, have a good night. Bye.